Welcome to Computex Cyber World Forum. This is Gary Lee, Associate Vice President of Telco Business Division from CubeCD, Quanta Cloud Technology. As a leading global data center solution provider, CubeCD has devoted ourselves into 5G infrastructure development since 2016. When the Telco Business Division was established, today we are very glad to have the opportunity to share how CubeCD drives the telco transformation with Open RAN technology. Moving into 5G era, volume deployment and rapid flexible service introduction are the necessity. With software-defined cloud-native hardware-software disaggregate technology, this open architecture will avoid specific vendor lock-in and eventually will benefit to all telco operators, not only to reduce the cost, but bring in innovation to the market as soon as possible to have competitive advantage eventually. Hereafter, CubeCD will not only follow 5G standard, but also proactively participate in two Open RAN related organization and community. Since 2019, CubeCD has joined the O-RAN Alliance with active engagement in two different PROGFests, including the first joint European O-RAN and T-PROGFest. Besides, CubeCD is the only Taiwan-based company successfully joined the Open RAN Policy Coalition. CubeCD is committed to involving RAN through continuous collaboration with open source community and ecosystem partners to realize the network interoperability and deploy truly open 5G solution. Next, I will have our business development manager to share more insight on Open RAN from both business and technical perspective. To you, Ulysses.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ulysses, and I'm the business development manager of Quanta Cloud Technology. And it's my honor to join the Computex Cyber World Forums and give you a speech today. So before we dive into the O-RAN topic, we need to figure out why O-RAN has been aroused a lot of market interest. As we all agree, the developments of the communication wireless technology represents the evolutions of human technology, and there are already many details about the textbooks illustrating the communication technology developments. But I would like to briefly divide the past the communication developments into three waves, namely digital integration, internet integrations, and the Internet of Things. In the first wave of digital integrations, the main task was to make the voice connections from fixed lines to wireless, so that calls between people to people were no longer limited in one area. And the cost of making a phone call was decreased. And this was a major evolution in 1G to 2G. And the second wave was internet integration. In addition to the voice connections, people were expecting more services through mobile phone. And we want video more than audio. We want pictures more than just text. We want to serve the internet and get the data timely and freely. So during these times, the cloud industry has arisen, and more data had been moved from local sites to the public cloud. So therefore, when 3G to 4G digital into internet, there is Netflix for movie video streaming, Spotify for music real-time streaming, and etc. No mentions, the social media has boosted and made the mobile phones become a necessity in our daily life. However, gradually we feel there are some limitations in the 4G. And 4G brings a lot of benefit for consumer level network. But how about enterprise level? How about internet for all things connected with greater bandwidth? Or could we provide different network services level based on actual user scenarios to have a better resource utilization? Therefore, here comes the third wave innovation, which is the software-defined architecture 5G technology. In order to reach the enterprise level service and communication, 5G needs to leverage the flexibilities and agilities of the software and transfer all the traditional and silo network functions into virtualizations. So when the network function has been virtualized, then the operator has the abilities to move in all the network functions from the core network all the way to the edge network, so that the operators have more abilities and also capabilities to put the computing power more close to the edge sites, which means bring more service opportunities to the end customers. And that will create and help them to create more new business models and bring new revenue streams in the near future. So the software defines 5G architectures. It means brings more computing powers everywhere and make the connections everywhere. But however, we all understand that technology still needs time to get involved. And when we talk about the IT and the communication technology to converge together, besides the innovations, we also need to look into the stabilities and also the reliabilities, which are the two key elements for the communication technology. That's the reason why ORAN has stand out and trying to define a range architectures and range standards for all the ecosystem partners to dive in and to help accelerate the 5G technology, especially for the RAN. Take this chart as example. If we want to talk about the network slicing for different use cases, no matter it is ultra low latency or enhanced mobile broadband or massive machines communications, it will require different locations of the RU or DUs, or even the CU's locations. So this needs to be defined and to be illustrated clearly and to understand what kind of RU designs or what kind of DU designs is suitable for the end user scenarios. When we take more into details into the ORAN alliances, ORAN has also defined their 5G RAN architectures into different group. Coming from the orchestrations or the intelligent controllers or the DUs or the RUs designs. There are already 26 operators and more than 300 companies has already joined the ORAN alliances and separate into different group. There are a total 10 working group discuss about the different topic and also form different task force to help the communities to deal with different challenges of the technology. So besides the technology discussions and also the product spec discussions, there will be an annual PlugFest activities to encourage the ecosystem partners and to provide their proof of concept integration status. Through the PlugFest, it will let the public to understand the current technical gaps and the directions for improvement. The improvement directions means the product design's directions and the market opportunity. And that is the reason why so many suppliers join the ORAN alliances. In this chart, there are Fujitsu, NEC, Kyocera, and Samsung to join as the vendor side with the key operators. They can take the chance and leverage the PlugFest to adjust their product marketing and go-to-market strategy. There's one more interesting thing that I would like to mention for the ORAN Alliance. ORAN has also understand the importance of 5G use cases. Because 5G is not only software-defined architecture, but also a service-based architecture. And since 5G technology has leveled up to enterprise from the consumer level, ORAN is expecting the RAN technology can be fitted into more down-to-earth user scenarios. On the other hand, ORAN is also using the use cases to drive the working group technical developments to be more precise. So in this chart, you can see that ORAN has already defined several use cases specifications and based on the different working group to identify the task and also the technology development's focus. And QCT has joined the ORAN Alliance since the very beginnings. Take these pictures examples. We have joined the Europe PlugFest with our partners' ecosystems. In this chart, QCT contributes as a DUCU's infrastructure solution provider, and we bring out stable platforms by using the Wind River. And also, we're doing some BMC and BIOS in the infrastructure low levels tunings, and also some critical component tunings to make sure when we are doing this PlugFest, there will be a stable platform to support these plug-face interoperability testings. So here, QCT's place an infrastructure solution providers, and we provide the DU, CU, not only the hardware, but also the platforms integrations for the partners. And of course, not only the PlugFest, not only the working group that we're discussing right now, there is still much work we need to do. The Orange, the missions, is trying to build up a better way to connect the world. And they have a three architectural target. So one is the virtualizations. Second is the interoperability testings. The third is the automations. In the virtualizations, there is still a lot of challenge. For example, the CPU core resource conflicts between the virtualization platforms and also the CUDU software's implementations. In the automation parts, we are still missing some of the service and management orchestrations. And we are hoping that there will be more stable SMOs in the near future when we're doing the PlugFest. And of course, the interoperability testings, including the performance tunings, are also a very highlight and also the very important factors when we are discussing in the ORAN community as well. So still, there's a lot of work need to do, and we expect more and more companies can join these open communities and to contribute yourself as well. So when people are talking about the 5G technology, they only see the service, the 5% of the service, and they only see the 5G end-to-end solutions. But underneath the C-levels, there is still a lot of work need to do. No matter it is application integrations, or the platform integrations, or the hardware components, or even the open ecosystem mindset want to input into the 5G architectures, there is still a lot of work to do, and it means we have a lot of opportunities to work in together and to join the Orange communities. So there's a lot of momentum ongoing right now at the Orange communities. And we expect more and more companies will dive in and contribute themselves into the alliances. Because we do see the momentum, we do see the power, we do see it. Everyone has devoted their knowledge into this and trying to make sure the 5G technology is innovative, but also maintains the reliabilities and also stabilities. So we'd like to call to action that we believe the new digital transformation has become, and also the ecosystem economy is coming as well. No matter you are focused on the AIs, no matter your core competence is the 5Gs or all the applications, or you're the leaders of the infrastructure providers, content provider, or you want to focus on the specific vertical industry like medical or entertainment, we hope all you can join and enjoy the journey of the 5G innovative architectures technology. With that, I would like to conclude my speech today. And if you want to have more information about the ORAN and also the Quanta Cloud technology, welcome to visit our website. Thank you very much. Goodbye.